Hello, I'm Maryna Didkovska, and I'm head of testing in Europe. I have a PhD in software reliability. That is why I'm quite excited to work and really use my theoretical and practical background. But what I would like to highlight is that initially I'm from development. And at the beginning of my career, I was working in AI domain. We were developing these plate number recognition systems. So AI in a nutshell before hype. And at that moment, still nothing has changed. It's more difficult to test these items than to develop them. Maybe the most important misconceptions that we have right now is that AI would replace somebody. Guys, that's awesome. That's brilliant expectation, but that's not the reality. And especially it's not the reality in the field of software test. You would have more job because it's extremely difficult to check that the system works properly, but still on the market, we have this position saving. Oh, some AI bot would replace me. And we have a joke that if you're asking this question, would AI replace me? Then actually the answer is always yes, because it means that you don't understand what you're doing. We cannot talk about replacement. We are not talking about replacement at all. We talk about enablement, that's accelerator. It's like you have a car right now. It provides you with possibility to drive faster, to reach to the point faster. But it doesn't mean that you shouldn't get to this place and you would be out of this car. That's just really good accelerator. So if you talk about EPAM and current changes based on different LLMs, I would say the first and the best for me personally improvement is improved coverage of unit tests, because if you have legacy systems, they are fragile, they're not in a good state, let's call it so. And team usually afraid to make changes in them. That is why AI-generated unit test coverage can significantly improve your life. And the second best option for me is a huge amount of manual test cases. We can transform them to some structure like BDD, then transform them to some other framework and have kind of better coverage than before. And the third and favorite. When you have, so, but it would be a mix between testing and business analysis. You have huge project and you don't remember all your data about the project, all the requirements. So you can shape the bot to grab information and ask the system to find similar requirements or some contradiction. And because it's text-to-text transformation, that's so beneficial. I like it. The biggest one, team resistance. The biggest and maybe the most painful is team resistance, because right now the market lacks of understanding what's going on under the hood. And we have this position saving, we have a lot of fears, we have a lot of myths, and that is why people try to compete with the tool. And especially if you're not mature enough, if you're not kind of senior that understands the technology, process converts like, look, Maryna, it's a problem here in tool. Look, it's not working 100% perfect, but we don't need 100%. It's about acceleration. That's a pain point. Maybe my favorite example when we misuse AI in the field of testing, when my team members try ask LLM to calculate some metrics. That's absolute misuse. It's not text-to-text transformation. And they say that, oh, it's not working properly because it cannot math. And I say, okay, it shouldn't. So it's about this understanding of system on the test. But if something is working not according to expectation, you say, I wouldn't use this tool because it's not working for me. But you misuse it. That's really a tricky question. You see, maybe because I work with really specific projects and you had to be control freak on these projects. So it's not on you, you say, but you prefer to manage the situation. You prefer to not to be tomorrow in reality. The version changed, and right now system provides absolutely different answers. That is why I prefer custom build solution, because I can manage them and they are under our control. But that's because of specific. If I would build something more common, something more traditional, then the cheaper version would be definitely better. Just not my piece of cake. Actually, I assume we would have a lot of AI infused applications. So we would try to integrate AI elements in our common software, like booking, I would say renting, et cetera, all these common things to reduce amount of human factor during support activities and so on. So conversational AI definitely would be in place. Yes, we would try to make something with reasoning. Other stages. My answer right now is, yeah, it's a good dream, but it wouldn't be in the next 2-5 years. So we wouldn't get organizational or other items in the next couple of years. First of all, because of huge budgets, because of cost optimizations all over the world. And that is why we cannot dream about Skynet, because we have other hero. We would be protected by budget issues all over the globe. Because right now, the bills for electricity, if you talk about LLMs and their work and corresponding service, they are the same as for all the Holland. So that's kind of really expensive. Can only imagine how much does it cost to handle all this amount of servers to run these activities. And if we would like to make them bigger, bigger, and bigger, that would cost a huge amount of money, resources, including water, to cool this system. Surprise. So they are not still waiting for Skynet. Sorry for disappointing.